Hello. Let us discuss the instruction set 8085. The instruction set is classified into five different categories. That is, data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logical instructions, branching instructions, and control instructions. Let us see what these are. Data transfer instructions. These are data transfer instructions. They move the data between two registers, between memory and register, and they can also copy the data from the source to the destination. That is, between two registers, when you say, one is called as a source, the other one is called as a destination. In this process of copying, the contents of the source and destination are not destroyed. Let us see what is the mnemonic for this. MOV refers to the mnemonic, and the operands RDRS. RD refers to the destination register, RS refers to the source register. M is here memory, RS is source. That means the contents are moved from source to memory. Here the contents are moved from memory to destination register, source to destination. The addressing mode, because you are using registers, it is called as a register addressing. And the length of these instructions is 1 byte, and it takes 4 T states for execution of this instruction. The T state here refers to the clock. T refers to the time states. 4 T states means 4 clock periods are required to execute this instruction. And what is this T? T is a time period which is reciprocal of the frequency. The frequency of the microprocessor 8085 designed for 3.02 MHz. So the time period will therefore be the reciprocal. So 1 by 3 MHz, that means around 0.33 microseconds. While executing this instruction, no flags are affected. The flags that generally affected are carry flag, sign flag, auxiliary carry flag, zero flag. None of these flags are affected because the contents are neither destroyed. They are only transferred from one source to the destination. Hence, flags are not affected. This instruction actually copies the contents of the source into the destination register. So move examples are move B, C, move B, M. B, C is, in this case, the register C is the source, register B is the destination. Similarly, when you say B, M, M is your memory address, which is indexed by the register HL pair. From there, the contents are moved into the register B. Similarly, we can also have immediate instruction. That is also a data transfer instruction. In the earlier case, in the case of MOV, we move the contents between two registers, between the memory and the register and vice versa. Here, MOV immediate is followed by a data. That means a data byte can be transferred into any of the registers. This is the data that can move into the register, or it can also move into the memory location. It is known as MOV immediate 8-bit data. Since it is an immediate instruction, it is an immediate addressing mode. The length is 2 bytes. So for every instruction, the first byte is always the opcode. The second byte will be the data. It's a byte. Byte is an 8 bit. So the data is 8 bits long that will be stored in the register. It takes, since it requires 2 machine cycles, it takes 70 states. First one is the opcode fetch, which takes 4 T states, and fetching the data byte takes 3 T states. So together it is 70 states. And here also, since it is only a data transfer, the flags are not affected. So for example, if the operand is in a memory location, its location is specified by the contents of the HL registers. So if you say move immediate B57 or move immediate M57, what actually are we doing? We are sending this data, which is 57, which is an 8-bit data, into the register B in this case, or into the register M in this case. Now let us see load instruction. Load instruction is load accumulator, and it is a 3-byte long instruction because it is followed by a 16-bit address. Well, how do you read this as load accumulator? What it means is you load the contents of the memory location, which is given by this memory location is always addressed by a 16-bit address. So those contents are moved into the accumulator. The addressing mode is register. The length is 3 bytes. In the case of move immediate, when we've written, move immediate is followed by data. So let us see load accumulator. As you are able to see, it is loading the accumulator. So the address contents are loaded into the accumulator. Let us see how are they designated. This way A, B, C, D, E, H, L, M, A, these are the registers which are designated as source, and this is your destination. So to move the contents from B to B, the opcode is 40. C to B, that means your destination is B. The data can be moved from B, C, D, E, H, L, M, A. So opcodes are 40, 40, but like this up to 47. Then from B to C, 48 up to 4F. Then from B to D, 50 to 57. Likewise, they are all designated. Now we've understood what is a move instruction, what is a move immediate instruction, what is a load instruction. Using these instructions, we can write simple programs and see how you enter the program. The steps involved in entering the program are, first on the microprocessor keyboard, say reset, and substitute memory button will be there. Press that, give the starting address from where you are writing the instructions. Go on pressing next, enter the program in successive memory locations. Continue till the end of the program. Then how do you execute? After you enter the program, the sequence of code, reset it, go to the starting memory location and execute. After you execute the program, the results are stored in the register. Depending on how you have written the program, it can be either stored in the register or it in the memory location. So to understand this, let us take a simple program. Write a program to load the data 0A in the register A and move it into successive registers B, C, D, E and M registers. The simple program is, since we have to first load it into the register A, we use an instruction called move immediate A 0A. So by writing this instruction, the data 0A is loaded into the register A. Then move B, A. Here B is your destination, your source is A. So from A it has moved to B. Then, so after you execute this instruction, after you enter these two, when you check for the contents of register B, it will have 0A and A also will have 0A. So it's only moved from A to B, A will still contain the same data because contents of the source are not destroyed. Then move B, C. From B it is moving into C. Or you can also say move A, C because A also is having the same data. Similarly, next C is going to D, or from A you can go to D. Then D to E, E to M, because you are asked to move it into the registers B, C, D, E, M. You can either give a halt or you can also give RST instruction. The difference is if you use a halt instruction, the program comes to an end, it will be terminated. To check the contents of the registers, you have to reset it and again check at different destinations. If you use RST, it is not terminated. You can execute the program and check the results. How do you write the program? This is the format in which you will be writing the program. The label, the address, the instruction and comments. Comments is for the user. That is for you to understand how the program is. After some time, you will not remember how you've written the program, what each instruction is doing, how the data is worked. So if you write the comment should be purely for your own understanding. How you write depends on how you are going to understand later. They are not to be executed. The comments are, for any other language also, the comments are non-executable part of the program. So this is the structure here. You will, for the microprocessor kit that we are using, the RAM is starting from F1000. So usually we write all the programs starting from F1000. And then instruction. Instruction is always consisting mainly of two parts. One is the opcode. The second one is operand. Opcode means is the machine code. It indicates what kind of operation that you are performing. Operand refers to the data on which your desired operation has to be performed. This is your machine code. So this machine code, depending on the type of instruction you are using, it can be 1 byte, it can be 2 byte, or it can be 3 byte. All the data transfer instructions, MOV, are all 1 byte instructions. Immediate instructions are 2 bytes. Whenever you are addressing data, if it is 8 bit data, it is a 2 byte long instruction. If it is a 16 bit data, it will be 3 byte long instruction. Then we also have address. Whenever address is being referred to, address being given by 16 bits of data. So we say it is a 16 bit address and it requires 3 bytes. So move this instruction, whatever instructions you have written, you should translate it. This is how you enter the program into the microprocessor kit. So first location F1000, you write move immediate A 0A. The opcode for move immediate A is 3E. This you can take it from the data sheets or the opcode sheets which are provided at the end of every textbook. So 3E is its opcode. And in the next location, when you press next on the kit, automatically the address will be pointed to F001. There you feed the data 0A. So by executing this instruction, what it does is the data 0A gets loaded into the register A. Then next you are writing move B, A. So A is, contents of A are moved to B. The opcode is 47, moves to B. All these instructions, these are all 1 byte long, you enter them in successive memory locations. You complete this, reset it, go to starting location and execute. After you execute, since you have to see the contents of the registers, go on pressing exam register A, you will see the 0A. Then next you press, it will go to B, next C, next D, next E, like that you can check the contents of all the registers. And all the registers will contain the same data 0A. This is how you execute this program. Next, till now we have seen only a single register. Now we are saying a register pair. When you see a register pair, load accumulator register pair. Load accumulator was followed by an address and it was a 3 byte long instruction. Now we are using load accumulator register pair. Whenever you see X in these instructions, it refers to a register pair. The only permitted register pairs are B and D. B means a BC pair, D means it is a DE pair. Load accumulator indirect. What it does is contents of the designated register pair point to a memory location. That means if you say B, BC pair refers to a memory location. If you say D, DE pair. What it does, it copies the contents of that memory location into the accumulator. The contents of either the register pair or the memory are not altered, flags are not affected, length is only 1 byte, T states are 7. So now what is it that you are doing? Load accumulator XB means you have some address which is given by a BC pair. And what is it? Suppose I say load accumulator register pair with B, and BC pair is having an address of something like F040. That means there is something already there in the location F040. What is there at F040 has to be brought into accumulator if it is addressed by BC pair. If it is addressed by DE pair, F040, if it is given the address to DE pair, the contents of that pair address will be loaded into the accumulator. Now, That was an indirect one. Now this is a direct addressing, or it's actually a register direct addressing. What it does, load register pair with data. There the data was given in some other memory location, load A, LDAXB, and from there it is brought to accumulator. Here there is no need, it is direct, because you are giving directly, X is always a register pair. You are giving this and you are giving the data directly. Let this one byte, T states the 10 flags are not affected. So for example, if I say LXIH2034, what it does mean, what it means is load register pair with this data instruction. So 20 gets loaded with H, the higher order address, 34 into the register L. Similarly, 0105, LXIB0105 means 01 is your higher order data that goes into register B. 05, the lower order address that goes into register C. Here D gets 11, E gets 43, H 21, L 74. Let us now see a simple program. Write a program to load this with the contents of the memory location F050. Assume F050 has 84. So write a program to load the accumulator with the contents of the memory location. So first HL pair is loaded with F050, that is the address that is required, and those contents are moved to accumulator using this instruction. So we've used the previous two instructions, load accumulator as well as load register pair immediate. Let us see how you translate it into a program. You are starting at F1000, so LXIB. It can be LXIB or LXIH. If I use H, we will use appropriate opcode. If I use B, we will use whichever you can use, you can use it. So LDAX, if I use H, I have used H here. Here I have used opcode as 01, so B. So accordingly, you will load it. This is what, it's a 3-byte long instruction. So first lower order address, then the higher order address. Load accumulator register pair B, and then this is the opcode, raise it. So accumulator gets loaded with the contents of F050. That is, 84 was assumed to be at F050, that gets loaded into the accumulator. Next, load. There it was only a single register. Now you are loading HL pair with this register. Load HL direct followed by the 16-bit address. So whenever there is a 16-bit address, length is 3 byte. These states are 16, flags are not affected, the addressing mode is register. This copies the contents of the memory location pointed by the 16-bit address into the register HL, into the register L. The contents of the next memory location are copied into H. So for example, if you take LHLD F040, contents of F040 are copied into L. Contents of F041 will get copied into H. So for example, if F040 is having a data 0A and F041 is having a data of 0B, after the instruction, what is happening? This 0A is getting moved into L. 0B, the next, the contents of the next memory location are transferred into H. There. Till now we have seen L, load accumulator, LDAXB, LHLD. These are all loading instructions. That means you are loading the accumulator from somewhere, from some memory location, from some register. Now the reverse is to store the contents from the accumulator into a different places. First at this address. So what it does is store accumulator followed by the 16-bit address. Contents of the memory accumulator are copied into the memory location which is specified by this address. So contents are there in the accumulator as well as at this location whichever is given here. Now that is a single register. Now this is X. X means register pair. So what it does, store accumulator indirect. That was a direct one. Now this is an indirect one. The contents of the accumulator are copied into the memory location specified by the contents of the register pair. So what are you writing here? STAXB. B refers to BC pair. If I write D, it will be store accumulator at DB pair. B, C, D, E and H. These are all the allowed ones. Let us see this program. Write a program to copy the contents of F500 and F501 to H and L registers. Just look at this program. If you look at this program, what you can see is, assuming F500 is having 04 as the data and F501 is having data 05. Assume this. So what are you asked to write? Program to copy the contents of F500 and F501 to H and L registers. So what will you do? Load HLD with F500. So H and L get copied. Move H to B. Move L to C. At the end of this program, B is having what is there in H, that is 04. C is having what is there in L, that is 05. Now write a program to store the contents of the accumulator at F503. Suppose you want to use this instruction, you can say LXIB F503. So what it does? Write a program to store the contents of the accumulator at F503. So BC gets this address F503. Move immediate A08, store accumulator F503. So what is happening here? You are already giving this address. You know what is there at this. And you want to store the contents of the accumulator into this. So what is there in F503? The data 08. And F502 with 8. This is how it will be converted. Store HL directly. So, contents of the register pair are stored in the memory location given by 16-bit address. Contents of the register H are stored in the next memory location. So, 2550 suppose you take. Contents of L are stored here. Contents of H will be stored at 255. See, this address, it depends on which kit you are using. Some kits use 2000 address, some kits use F1000. Accordingly, depending on which system you are working, you have to choose the address like that. This is another instruction which is used to transfer the data. Exchange, XCHG refers to exchange H with D. The contents of the register H are exchanged with the contents of the register D. And L are exchanged with E. H goes to D, L with E. Stack pointer. So this copy the contents of the HL pair onto the stack pointer. When we see the program, we will see this. This is exchange HL with the top of the stack. Load the program counter with HL contents. Push. Push and pop are the instructions which are used to actually send the information or the data onto the stack. So push is to write the data onto the stack, pop is to read the data from the stack. The contents of the register pair are copied onto the stack. SP is, see, whenever you are doing, stack means it is always referring to the top of the stack. So SP is decremented and the contents of the registers, whichever register you are giving, are copied into the stack. Again, it will be decremented. Then the lower order registers will be copied onto the stack. So if you say push B first, the contents of B immediately will be pushed onto, after it is decremented, they will be pushed in. Once again it will be decremented, contents of C will be pushed on. Pop is the reverse. So if you push B, push means you are pushing B first, then C first, C later. B is pushed first, then C comes. When you pop, it is in the reverse order. C comes out first, then comes B. Contents of the stack are copied into the register pair. Contents of the location pointed out by SP are copied into the lower order addresses, which is incremented again, then B will come. You have two instructions. This is to send the data from processor to a port. This port is a device which is used to load or unload data, and it is an 8-bit port. So the contents of the accumulator are copied into the I/O port. Usually these instructions are used for interfacing, that is when you are using microprocessor to communicate with the outside world. So suppose you want to send the data to a CRO or to a printer or any other interfacing devices, we use out. When you want to read from that, you will use in. This is in instruction. You are saying receiving, the processor will be receiving the data from the port. Port is loading or unloading. Loading when you are writing operation, unloading when you are doing reading operation. Next, let us go on to arithmetic instructions. They are addition, subtraction, increment and decrement. Addition, always addition is a binary operation. Addition is a binary operation, meaning thereby that it requires two operands. And it is always assumed that one of the operands is always in the accumulator. The other operand can be either in any of the registers or in the memory location. When we perform the operations of addition or subtraction, the results of the operation are always stored in the accumulator. And in this particular arithmetic instructions, the flags are all affected. Let us see how the flags are affected. If you are adding two numbers, two 8-bit numbers, and if there is an overflow, that means if you are adding something like 1 plus 1, the result is going to be 1, 0. 0 will be stored as 8th bit. This 1 will come as a 9th bit, which is reflected in the carry. So when you check for the contents of the flag register, carry flag will be affected. And similarly, if you are using subtraction, say suppose you are taking the data X in register A, and in register B, suppose you take again X. If you say subtract B, the register A is having the data X, register B is also having the data X. When you say sub B, subtract B, X minus X is 0. In this case, 0 flag is affected. And when you are subtracting a larger number from the smaller number, you are going to get a negative sign. Thereby, the sign flag is affected. Then auxiliary flag. Auxiliary carry, what it does is, when you are performing 8-bit operations, let us say addition, if there is a carry from the 4th bit to the 5th bit, then auxiliary carry is affected. That is, 4 bits, first 4 bits, 0, 1, 2, 3, refers to the lower order byte of the data. Then 4, 5, 6, 7 bits refer to the higher order data. If there is a carry from lower byte to the upper byte, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 3rd bit to the 4th bit, the auxiliary carry is affected. So this is how all the flags are affected in these arithmetic instructions. So here the contents of the register or the contents of the memory location can be added to the contents of the accumulator. The result is stored in the accumulator. No two other 8-bit registers can be added directly. It can be done only through accumulator. And the contents of the register B cannot be added directly to the contents of the register C. It has to be only through the accumulator. So what are the instructions used to load the data into the register B? You can say move immediate B data 1, move immediate C data 2, move B to A, add C. Or directly move this data 1 into A, and you can still use add C. And if you use store accumulator 5040, what is it doing? When you say add C, contents of C and contents of A are added. The result is at A. Imagine data 1, which is stored in the register B, is AB. Data 2, which is 45, is stored in the register C. By executing this instruction, you are adding AB plus 45. The result, whatever you are getting, is expected to be in the accumulator. If you want to see the result elsewhere, in a particular memory location, then you can say store accumulator F040. That means the result is going to be loaded in the accumulator as well as in this memory location, which is F040. Now let us see what is the data. B plus 5. B is 11. Plus 5, 16. 16 is 10. There is a carry here. 1 plus 4 is 5. 5 plus A is 10. 15. 15 is F0. So when you execute this program, you will see the data F0 in which location? In F040 as well as in the accumulator. Subtraction. Similarly, the same way. As you have seen the addition, even this is going to be the same way. Here, there is a carry. If there is a carry of the 8th bit, carry flag is set. Here, carry is treated as borrow. Those are the arithmetic instructions. Then we have logical instructions. Increment or decrement. So the 8-bit contents of the register or a memory location can be incremented or decremented by 1. The 16-bit contents also can be incremented or decremented. So increment A, increment M, decrement A. A means A register. If I say B, we will say contents of the register B are decremented or incremented. Okay, the same way, add or RM, add with carry. Another instruction is, suppose you are using 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3 bits. 1 plus 1 will give you 1 carry, 0 the sum. The 0 plus third bit will be added, you will get the data as 1, 1. So this is add with borrow or add with carry. So adding, these are the opcodes. Anding, CMP, INR, DCR. Decrement, increment, compare. Compare is again what it is. It is actually comparing the two numbers. You can use this instruction to find the larger, let us say, of the two numbers X and Y. Compare, you load the number X into register A, load the number Y into register B, and use the instruction compare B. If A is greater than B, carry is not set. If A is less than B, carry is set. What actually this compare, what it does is, it compares two numbers. Actually, it subtracts. X minus Y it does. If X minus Y is negative, that means what? X is less than Y. If X minus Y is greater than 0 or positive, we say X is larger than Y. The carry is not set. Here, it performs subtraction, but it does not store the results anywhere. Unlike subtraction, the results are stored in the accumulator. This is a fundamental difference between subtract instruction and a compare instruction. This is how the opcodes are generated. Add immediately. Now, we have seen till now how to add two registers, contents of the two registers. As we have move immediate, we also have add immediate. That means whenever there is an immediate, immediately the data has to be given. So the data which is given in the second byte are added to the contents of the accumulator. And the results are always stored in the accumulator. Flags are modified and they are going to reflect the result of the addition. So for example, if you use add immediate 45 and if A has 56, what it does? 45 plus 56 will be added and the result will be stored in A. 5 plus 6 is 11, which is B. 4 plus 5 is 9, that is 9. And this 9B will be stored in the accumulator. There is another interesting double addition, DAD. This adds register pair to HL pair directly. So, the results are stored in the HL pair. So what are the register pairs which are allowed, as we have already seen? Either a BC pair, DE pair, or it can be HL. DAD H means it adds to itself. So LXIH 2040, load register pair immediate HL with 2040, load register pair immediate BC with this, and if you say DAD B, what it does? 4020 is added, 4 plus 2 6, 0 plus 0 0, 0 plus 0 0, 2 plus 3 5, 50 60, 50 goes into H, 60 goes into L. If you don't use this, if you use directly DAD H, that means 2040 gets added to 2040. What will you get? 48. We've already seen increment and decrement. This is increment and decrement the registers. Now let us see logical instructions. What are they? Anding, oring, xoring, rotating, comparing, complementing. All this is done with the contents of the accumulator. So any 8-bit data or the contents of the register or memory location can logically ANDed, XORed and so on. So if you take, let us take A, F as your data in A, C, D is the data in your B, let us see what happens. So now let us see, continue with that. AF 1010A, 111 is F, C 1100 and D is 1101. So when you do AND, 11 AND is 1, 01 is 0, 10 is 0, 00 is 0, 11 is 1101. So read this data, what do you read this as? 8 and this is D. If you say A or B, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1 is 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0 is 0, 1, 1 is 1, 1, 1, 1. So when you OR it, what are you getting? This is E and this is F. XORing, you are getting this is 6 and this is 2. What you observe is A and B. When you say A and B, what are you getting? Whatever this number, you will get the same number here. A and B. A 11, 1010 is becoming, where there is 0, it always gets 0. This is 1, this is 0. So A and B is this, A or B is this, exclusive or B is this. So you will get A and B is 8D. Is it 8D? 8D. A or B is EF. Let us see. This is E and this is F. Then XRB is 6-2, 6 and 2. You can try with different data. Now we have rotate instructions. Rotate right, rotate left. This is, if there is a C in the instruction, that means it is rotate accumulator left. L, R means right, without carry. If there is a C in the instruction, it is without carry. If there is no C, RAR and RAL, it is rotate accumulator right or left with carry. Then you have CMA, complement accumulator, CMC, complement carry. Let us take this example. Let us say A is 8-2. 8-2. Okay. D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. RRC is right. Rotate right is executed. The contents of AR 41. Why? It is getting divided by 2. Right it is going. So 1, this 1 is going here, this 0 is going here, 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, this 1 goes here. What is there in D0 comes here. So how do you read this data as? This is 4, this is 1. So shifting right is division by 2. If you shift this again by another, you will get another number. So shifting right is division, shifting left will be multiplication. Now let us see RLC. So 82 once again, 1000, 8 and 2. Now you are rotating left. So this 0 comes here, this 1 will come here, this 0 comes, 0 comes, 0 comes, 0 comes, this 0 is coming here, this is coming. So now what's happening here? So therefore, this 82 will become the other one. Same thing is, these are branching instructions. You have conditional or unconditional.